So it's been 30 years. Are you excited about this new release?
Absolutely. You know, when the film was first released in the U.S., they put out this, I don't know, I call it a bastardized version of the film. They made it in chronological order. They took all the poetry out of the film. That is in the U.S. The rest of the world got a long version and got to see the film, and the rest of the world embraced it. Here, it kind of opened with a dud, and now only through time has the film been appreciated and loved again. So I'm really happy to see Sergio's cut hit the screen and be a part of it again.
You've seen it already?
No, this is going to be the first time I've seen Sergio's actual cut.
So you think it's the definitive version?
I'm quite positive it is. If the maestro says it is, I'm sure it is. Yeah.
Now, who's responsible for restoring this film to its director's cut?
You know, to be honest, I'm not sure. I'm not sure exactly who was involved in. You know, I know that Sergio's family. I mean, everybody wanted to see Sergio's version of the film. When the movie was released, I know it broke his heart. It at least when the U.S. version was released, and so But actually, who did it? I'm not really sure. So
they just don't make movies anymore like they used to.
You will never see a movie like this again. The time that was taken, how meticulous Sergio was, the brilliant cast that surrounded it, and just the fact that they would do nothing until he thought it was absolutely perfect. And you just never see anything like that again, I don't believe. So
tell us a little bit about your involvement in the film.
Well, I was, very young in my career. I had a few credits in movies. And I got an audition, and I came in the room, and I really didn't even know what I was going in for. It was like that quick. And the next thing I know, I got called back to meet Sergio, and he studied me with his eyes for about 10 minutes, I think, before he said a word to me. And then he told me, he said, in my movie, he said, there is a character named Cockeye. He said to me, when I always dreamed of this character, he said, I always saw your face. So, a good day for me.
Now, all the interiors were shot in Rome and all the exteriors in New York?
They built streets in Rome as well and in Brooklyn. Our part, as adults, I filmed in Rome and in Montreal. And then they came for the kids' part into Brooklyn and then back to Rome. It was really pretty amazing to walk down some street in Rome and it looked like Brooklyn. So
have you seen these guys in the late past 30 years?
Yes, I have. Yes, not every day, but yes, I have. They're grand gents, truly.
There was a lot of camaraderie on the set?
Absolutely. It was amazing. We went weeks early. We spent time. We rehearsed. And we did it all the right way, the way that it should always be done, but it's not. And through that, the relationships that ended up on the screen, developed. And so it was an amazing experience, truly. At the time, I was young, and I was, just using my head as a battering ram trying to get into the business, and I appreciated it. But now, after 30 years, you realize it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. We rehearsed a lot. We would break down the script, sit down, work it. Sometimes changes were made. I mean, whatever made it until it was finally to the point that it was ready to shoot. But we didn't shoot until it was ready. I mean, I remember one day we rehearsed. I want to say we rehearsed 2 days before we actually shot the scene. So it was perfection was definitely the day.
Congratulations. Great talking to you.